What's up, guys? So JP is getting a brand new summonable LR very, very soon. And while I've heard some mixed reactions and feelings to this news, I'm gonna be honest with you. I personally really, really like it. And if I was more of a JP player, if I actually played the JP version more, I might find it kind of hard to completely skip whatever banner that they end up coming on. But fortunately, I am a global main, so I probably don't have to worry about it for at least another 6 months or so. But of course, I am talking about the brand new LR Trunks and Mai. And I might be a little bit biased here considering Trunks and Mai are two of my favorite characters from Dragon Ball Super, but I also think that their super attacks are very, very badass. You should be seeing it on the screen right now. I should be playing it for you. Probably was playing for the whole time, honestly, but I think it's very cool. There's something about Trunks and Mai working together that is freaking dope to me. So let me know in the comments down below what you guys think of the brand new super attack animations for this new LR as well. It's honestly not as flashy as some of the other new animations we've seen recently. LR Goku and Frieza come to mind. The cooler one's pretty flashy as well as the end Goku Black. But even though it's not as flashy, even though it's not as crazy or anything, I don't know. I just really like it. there's something about it that's very charming, that's very... It's nice. That's all I gotta say. I guess I'm not really good with describing why I feel certain ways about things, but I like it a lot. Enough rambling from your boy Tiger. Let's jump into what the card actually does. So, first things first, leader skill. It's for the Beyond Time and Space category, or also known as the Time Travelers category. It doesn't really matter what you want to call it, but it's the same category as the new Int Goku Black on JP. So there's that. And they give that category Ki plus 4, HP attack and defense plus 130%. And also they give super SDR units Ki plus 4 and HP attack and defense plus 100%. So it's a little bit lower in terms of percentage compared to the Int Goku Black, but they do give plus 4 Ki as opposed to 3 Ki. Now, most of the time you still probably want to run the Int Goku Black as a double lead, but this is a good option as well if you don't have the Int Goku Black, or maybe you want that extra key to get more of those Ultra Supers off, considering the category has a ton of LRs on it. So I don't know, I like it. It's not like a crazy overpowered leader skill like LR Goku and Frieza, but you guys will find out as we go through this that this is more of a well-balanced LR compared to the LR Goku Frieza. And for those of you who've been watching my channel for a while, Don't think of this as me just hating on Goku Frieza because I don't have them, which I don't. I still don't. I really want it, but I don't have it. But it's just like that card was broken, right? That card was mad broken. They decided to make it super overpowered, and it's gonna make newer LRs that come after it or new cards that come after it a little bit underwhelming in comparison because they're not gonna be as broken. But honestly, this is a very well balanced LR, and I feel like this is around the level where the current LRs should be. Moving on to the passive, they get an attack buff of 70% to start as a base, and then they get an additional attack and defense plus 10% per time traveler category ally on the team, up to 70%. Now, in theory, that would mean that if you're running a full time traveler category team, then they get attack plus 140% and defense plus 70%, but I don't know exactly how those numbers are calculated, so it very well could be higher than those percentages I just gave you. And lastly, they get Ki plus 6 and high chance to dodge when facing a future Saga category enemy. If you guys don't remember, that's the category that's led by physical future Gohan. And for their super attacks, they look very, very cool, but the effects are pretty standard. So for their 12 Ki super, it deals colossal damage with a medium chance to stun the enemy, and the 18 Ki super deals mega colossal damage with a high chance to stun the enemy. And their links are Courage, Brainiacs, Cold Judgment, Dismal Future, Prepare for Battle, Fierce Battle, and Legendary Power. So overall, pretty solid links. And of course, I also want to give credit to the person who translated all this information, DDRose2 on the Dokkan subreddit. Thank you so much for making it possible for me to make this video, because I can't read Japanese and I wouldn't have been able to translate that stuff all by myself. So huge shout out to DDRose2 on the Dokkan subreddit. But there you go, guys. That is the brand new LR Trunks and Mai card that is coming to JP. And honestly, like I said, very well balanced card. Doesn't seem like it's gonna deal insane amounts of damage, but they're gonna deal good damage, and they have good stats as well, as you can see on the card art, which should be on the screen somewhere right now. So overall, solid unit. There have been a few that have been a little bit underwhelming recently as far as summonable LRs go. LR Bardock comes to mind, and there's also been some other ones who have been mad broken, like LR Goku and Frieza. I might put LR Super Saiyan 3 Goku in that category as well because of his insane damage, but he's more of just a damage dealer, so I guess he's a little bit more balanced than Goku and Frieza, but overall, good LR, good leader skill, solid links, and good passive. So there you go, guys. Let me know in the comments down below what you think of this new LR, whether you'll be summoning for it if it comes out on a... I guess it really depends on what kind of banner it comes out on, right? It could come out on their own individual legendary summon banner, or it could just be a unit that's on a upcoming Rising Dragon Carnival banner, which would also be a thing. Actually, I don't know if they've announced that news yet, because I haven't been too tuned in to what's going on in JP, but either way, I think they're great. But hear me out for a second here. I've been thinking about this ever since I saw the news for this upcoming Trunks and Mai card, and I could be totally off base here, but what if we're moving into this new meta where we're going to be getting a bunch of couple themed cards, right? Of course, Trunks and Mai, they're a Dragon Ball couple, and honestly one of my favorite couples in the series, but that's besides the point. But what if we get more cards like this, where we get like a couple as the characters in the card, right? So for example, let me explain myself. For example, what if we get a Goku and Chi-Chi card, which is something I've been asking for a very, very long time. And it doesn't even have to be like a Dokkan Fest card, man. It could be a free-to-play card, or maybe it just is a random card they add as part of another unit's Dokkan Fest banner or something like that. But either way, I think a Goku and Chi-Chi card would be badass if they have some kind of like combination attack, just like Mai and Trunks here have with this new LR. And that'd be awesome. Or also, you can have a Krillin and 18, right? How is there no Krillin and 18 card? How is there no good Krillin card in this game when Yamcha, literally Yamcha, got an LR, even if it's a free-to-play LR. Freaking Yamcha got an LR, and it's actually a very good LR, at least for the leader skill. I mean, it just makes no sense. So Krillin and 18 would be awesome. As I mean, I might be a little bit biased here, again, because I love 18 as a character too. So I think that'd be dope, or maybe a Gohan and Videl, but not Saiyan Man like 1 and 2, but actually like an Ultimate Gohan and Videl doing some combination fights, that'd be like, or combination attacks in their super, that'd be awesome. You can even throw Pan in there if you want, or maybe even Vegeta and Bulma. And I know people are gonna be like, yo, there's already a Vegeta and Bulma, the Rage Vegeta, right? But how about we have a Bulma with Vegeta that actually does something, as opposed to just getting the ever-living crap slapped out of her multiple times every single turn. That's literally her only role in that card, right? She gets slapped, and then Vegeta rages out and counters, which is dope. I love that scene from Super, one of the best scenes in the entire anime, but an entire show. But, you know, I think Bulma deserves some more love than that. I think she can do more than just getting slapped. Maybe she's like driving or like flying in a spaceship and shoots some missiles at the enemy or something like that. That'd be cool. So, there's really nothing, no point to this conversation. There's no point in what I'm saying right now, except for the fact that I've been thinking about this. I think it'd be dope. And if it does end up happening, I want to be able to, you know, show people this clip from this video being like, yo, I called it right here. At this point in the video, I was talking about these couple cards that I wanted to see happen, and I was predicting could possibly happen based on this LR we're getting, the Mai and Trunks and Mai, as well as the fact that we have this new combinations category now, which I do still think will get a like summonable Dokkan Fest unit to lead it that gives like 150%, 170% or more, possibly for the 4th year anniversary on JP. Possibly. Keep that in mind too, guys. Another possible prediction that could come to fruition on JP sooner than you might think, but that's all I gotta say today, guys. We went over the new LR Trunks and Mai. I think it's great. Still want to hear opinions about what you guys think about it, and also let me know what you think about this idea of this couple card meta that we could potentially be going into. Which ones do you want to see the most? Is it Goku and Chi-Chi? Is it Gohan and Videl? Or some other random couple that I can't even think of right now? I don't know. freaking Kami and Popo. I don't know, man. But let me know your ideas. I would love to have a conversation with you guys in the comments down below. But that's going to do it for the video. That's all from me. As always, if you guys like the video, make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me and you like what you see, then make sure to hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell as well so that YouTube knows you're going to stay up to date with all of my latest content. But I'm out of here. Hope you guys have a fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.